Record the road with your phone every time you drive and get rewarded for it with tokens. That's what I'll be talking about today. The DePIN project ROVR, what it is, their two devices we can earn with, how the rewards work, and at the end I'll give you my thoughts on ROVR. And if you like the content, make sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, and if you want to see all of my crypto miners, my setup tutorials, and cheapest places to find these DePIN miners, check out nordiccrypto.io, link is in the description. ROVR is a decentralized platform collecting super detailed 3D and 4D data using devices you can put on your car. And this data these devices collect is accurate, and it's the kind of accuracy needed for autonomous vehicles to navigate roads safely, for robots to understand their surroundings, or for creating realistic virtual worlds. Here's how ROVR works, where a user collects data. You drive with the ROVR device on your car, either using your phone or this big device, and it captures things like road signs, lane markings, and buildings in 3D. And that raw data then gets processed into high-quality maps or dataset for industries. ROVR's already got around 2,800 active devices mapping around the world and more than 20 million kilometers across 50 plus countries, which you can see here on their Explorer. So they've already done quite a lot, but this is quite a small number and means that we are quite early with ROVR still, and you will see why here soon. Let's start with ROVR's main device, the TarantulaX, priced at $199. It's a device you mount on your car's roof. It uses a strong magnet to stick, and the device connects to your phone via Bluetooth. The Tarantula then uses your phone's camera to record road details like lane lines or traffic signs. But it also boosts your phone's GPS accuracy from meters down to just 2 centimeters. It does this by tapping into GeoNet's real-time correction network, another big DePIN project. To use the Tarantula, you just plug it into your car's USB port or to a power bank that powers the device, and then set up your phone in a holder so that it can record the street. Then just use the ROVR app to start mapping while you drive. The setup is very simple, and the app guides you to align your phone's camera, and you're good to go as long as you're driving between 10 km per hour and 120 km per hour. The Tarantula itself is waterproof, and it's got a security chip to make sure the data you collect is legit and can't be faked. You currently earn 1.6 ROVR tokens per kilometer you drive with the Tarantula X. So if you're driving a lot, starting to use the Tarantula to earn a little bit from it is quite easy and affordable, compared with other forms of earning crypto. ROVR's more expensive device, the LightCone, is a beast when it comes to recording. It's packed with a LiDAR scanner, a 4K HD camera, a high-precision inertial measurement unit, and a powerful processor for real-time data analysis. It captures 3D content up to 200 meters away with a 3 to 5 centimeter accuracy. And this LightCone you also mount on your car's roof with a magnet base and an anti-slip mat, connecting it to a power source, and it uses a 1TB SSD to store the data. The ROVR app then controls everything while you are driving, and after your trip you need to upload the data from the SSD at home. So it's a bit more involved than using the Tarantula X, but the payoff is a lot more since you earn 16 ROVR tokens per kilometer with LightCone, so it's 10 times more than with the Tarantula X because of the richer data. The LightCone is built to handle extreme weather and it's waterproof, so it's ready for any kind of weather out there. This device, the LightCone, you can also get 5% off, making it quite a lot cheaper, and that is also only available over at nordiccrypto.io. So this device is only for those who are really serious about ROVR, believe in their vision, and you are driving a lot. Keep in mind that ROVR only sell a few of these LightCones in each batch, and when this batch is sold out, there is a little time until the next batch is released, and we don't know if that batch will be cheaper or more expensive per device, but either way I think you will still be able to get the 5% discount on it from here. How does the ROVR rewards work and its tokenomics? The ROVR token exists on the Solana blockchain with a fixed supply of 10 billion, where 51% of all of those tokens is set aside for community contributions like you and me. You earn these tokens by driving and collecting quality data, but there are a few things to keep in mind. The token rewards will be halved every year, starting April 26, 2025, so getting in early during these first years to drive a lot and get a lot of tokens is the best way to maximize your earnings. Also, if you map the same roads repeatedly, rewards from those areas drop by 50% every 2 revisits to push you to explore new routes. One important aspect when recording data for ROVR is the data quality. The top tier data gets you 100% of the reward, but lower quality data might drop you down to 75, 50, or even 25% of the rewards. So make sure you're using your phone with a good camera and that you record the entire road. The ROVR token rewards are also calculated and paid out weekly to its users. There's also good measures in place against cheating. If someone uses multiple devices in one car, you get zero rewards and risk a ban from it. It's a system built to reward real effort and keep things fair. ROVR are also looking to burn 60% of the tokens that are earned from data sales when companies buy and utilize the collected data. This will then over time help reduce the token supply of the ROVR token. The most important part of ROVR's rewards and tokenomics is definitely that they are giving more than half of their token supply to their users, which is a good sign that they are prioritizing those who collect the data. The other part to keep in mind is the yearly halving event in reward amount. ROVR has secured partnerships with both GeoNet and IoTeX, two of the most prominent DePIN projects out there in my opinion. This kind of collaboration really shows ROVR's growing influence within the DePIN sector. On April 29th, 2025, IoTeX participated in a seed round investment in ROVR, while GeoNet co-led a 2.6 million seed round alongside Borderless Capital and others. So these famous DePIN projects are definitely seeing something in ROVR. No project is perfect, so let's talk about some hurdles ROVR might face. To be fair, I have used the TarantulaX only a little bit while driving. The LightCone I have not tried out myself yet. Where I live, it's not allowed to record people however you want, and I know these DePIN projects that record while driving have measures against that by blurring faces and registration plates and such, so there isn't really an issue. But either way, I'm not that into needing to explain and show proof of that if the cops were to stop me when I'm driving. I don't know, let me know in the comments what you think of this specific issue. Have you been stopped and asked about your DePIN devices before? If so, let me know in the comments and tell me what happened. There are already a bunch of other mapping projects out there, so there's definitely competition. What stands out to me about ROVR is the sheer amount of data on their site and their thoughts going into it, and of course also their good partnerships. And the fact that the barrier to enter ROVR and start mapping is often a lot lower than with many other mapping projects, mainly due to us being able to map with the cheap TarantulaX and our phone. It then becomes a lot easier for a network to scale, grow users, and thereby collect a lot more usable data, which is the most important part for a DePIN project like this. ROVR's data has attracted interest from large companies. As of June 2025, ROVR has signed multiple letters of intent and begun fulfilling paid contracts with international vendors for their datasets. But so far, as we know right now, we have not seen any of these go through fully, so that is still yet to come. And this could perhaps lead to a big boom for ROVR eventually if it's doing collaborations with big companies, and those companies then start using their data. ROVR definitely have taken the steps, creating the infrastructure needed, made good partnerships to establish themselves as a serious DePIN project. That is basically what all projects are aiming for, and ROVR have definitely, in my opinion, reached that status. Due to ROVR's upcoming partnerships regarding using their data are still to come, there is a yearly halving to the token rewards for us mapping, and there is still not that many users out there providing data. I think there is a feeling of urgency to participate with ROVR as soon as possible, because it very much seems that they are favoring early participations. Even though that's the case, it's still not certain that ROVR will get enough users, won't collect enough data, that big companies would be interested. So that becomes, as with all investments, a deciding point for you to determine if you want to participate or not. ROVR have had their ROVR token already listed, so there is not going to be an upcoming boom-like event where loads of tokens come in one swoop. With ROVR, I think it's going to be a slow success over time if they manage to get success through continued growth of their network and partners who buys and utilize their data. Let me know what you think about ROVR and these devices down in the comments. Alright, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.